Hey everyone, welcome back to Installation 00. This is Law and Theory, and today we're discussing the entire known MA5 series of weapons used by the UNSC. Let's dive in. The MA5 series, collectively known as the MA5 Individual Combat Weapon System, is a series of air-cooled, gas-operated assault rifles produced by Misria Armouries. Part of the larger MA series, the MA5 is the workhorse of the United Nations Space Command. Having been in service for more than 50 years, the MA5 series is the oldest rifle platform currently being utilised by the UNSC, with more than a dozen models still in use. While the UNSC Marine Corps and the Navy use the MA5 designation, the Army refers to the weapon as the MA-37. The MA5 series rifle is a magazine-fed weapon designed for automatic fire. It has an attached electronic suite that provides information on rounds remaining in the magazine, compass heading, as well as several other housekeeping functions. The rifle is rugged and sturdy, and performs exceptionally well in a variety of environments, especially given the perceived delicacy of the attached electronic suite. The MA5 rifle can be outfitted with a number of modifications, including sound suppressors, a grenade launcher, an underslung shotgun, or a standard issue flashlight. The sound suppressor can be attached to the barrel to reduce the amount of noise and flash generated by firing the weapon. The M301 40mm grenade launcher can be fitted under the barrel, replacing the flashlight attachment standard to the MA5 series. Hellbringers were equipped with this to launch flashbang grenades to stun and surprise enemy troops. The launcher is capable of firing 40mm grenades at targets within a 99-foot or 30-meter zone, and up to 164 feet or 50 meters vertically, depending on wind, trajectory, and skill. The grenade launcher's rare tendency to detonate in the hands of unskilled operators has led to the M301 seeing limited use. The underslung shotgun has precious little information about it. All that is known is that it can be attached under the barrel in place of the flashlight to aid in close quarters combat, while the flashlight appears to be the preferred and default attachment. The MA5 series rifle is a close to medium range weapon. It is most effectively used by fully automatic, sustained fire at close range, or by using short controlled bursts at medium range. Because of this, it is most effective at close range. That is not to say that in the hands of a skilled operator, however, that it can't be used at longer ranges, but simply that it is most effective at close to medium range. The MA5 series rifle is a bullpup rifle and is made of titanium A alloy. The rifle is gas operated and fires from a closed bolt. The charging handle used to chamber the round is situated on the left side of the rifle and moves during operation. Once the first round is fired, the gases from that round and those to follow impinge upon a gas piston, which pushes back the bolt carrier, rotating the bolt inside, which unlocks it and extracts the spent brass from the chamber and ejects it. As the bolt carrier group is propelled forward, it chambers another round. This cycle continues until the magazine is empty. Once the magazine is empty, the charging handle must be both pulled back and locked, or must be fully cycled after a fresh magazine is inserted to chamber the next round. The magazine itself is located at the butt of the rifle, and the magazine release button is located above the magazine well and has an arrow pointing down towards the housing. The electronic suite is integrated along the top rail guard of the weapon. The MA5 is designed for the toughest of situations, able to be subjected to elements that would otherwise cause a weapon to malfunction or render a weapon inoperable. The electronic suite contains an LED ammunition counter that displays the number of rounds remaining in the inserted magazine, as well as displaying a magnetic compass. The suite can also project a target in reticle onto the user's heads-up display or neural interface. If such equipment is not available, pop-up iron sights within the cowling can be used. You heard that right. The Halo assault rifle actually has iron sights. After trawling the internet and sources as much as humanly possible, I can confirm that those two notches located on the upper cowling are apparently where the concealed iron sights are located. You can see more clearly in this image, which is actually taken from the in-game model from Halo 5. In the image, you can make out the prongs to assist in aiming. So there you have it, it is confirmed the assault rifle has hidden iron sights. The MA5 series rifle uses the M118 7.62x51mm full metal jacket armor-piercing round. These rounds are designed to pierce body armor, so the rounds are reasonably large and are surrounded by a molded jacket of metal which enhances its armor-piercing capabilities. More exotic ammunition types like shredder rounds are available for use. However, these modifications are available only by mission conditional requisition. The MA5 entered service within the UNSC Armed Forces in 2395 and has remained the primary service rifle ever since. So at the current in-game timeline, the MA5 series has actually been in service for 165 years. In 2437, it was adopted by the UNSC Army. The MA5 series was preceded in service by the MA3A Individual Combat Weapon System, which itself was preceded by the MA2B and the MA1, and these are the current known versions of the MA5 series. The MA37, the UNSC Army's designation of the MA5, was introduced in 2437 and is still favoured heavily by the Army despite newer iterations of the series due to its ruggedness and simplicity. The MA37 has a more skeletal cowling than other MA5 variants. The MA37 assault rifle is air-cooled, gas-operated, magazine-fed, fully automatic bullpup rifle that fires 7.62x51mm ammunition, and it comes standard with a rail-mounted ammunition indicator and magnetic compass for orientation, unlike other MA5 series rifles, which have these features built in. The MA37 features a grip with a notch for the finger similar to the A2 pistol grip on the 20th to 21st century AR-15. The barrel features a flash hider on the end which appears to be designed to direct gas which produces flash and noise upward rather than forward, which would help to reduce the felt recoil and muzzle climb. The rifle features a cheek riser on the receiver. The MA37 also features an ambidextrous magazine release and an ambidextrous selector switch. The MA37 also features vents on the rifle chassis near the barrel assembly, which facilitate air cooling of the barrel as the weapon fires. While we're on the subject of cooling, it is interesting to note that some variants of the MA5 series have been witnessed being used in the vacuum of space. Heating in this circumstance would then become a growing issue because the rifle wouldn't be able to cool via convection and induction with the air surrounding it, reducing the means of cooling simply by radiation or direct conduction through its own frame. It is unclear if some variants feature a more complex cooling system utilizing perhaps a liquid coolant, radiators, or even electronic heat pumps, as ultimately excess heat buildup in a weapon can be catastrophic. But I digress. The MA5B individual combat weapon system is much less accurate in comparison to the MA5C and MA5D. It is often relegated to use in short-range combat, although again, in the hands of a skilled operator, it can be used to medium and even long range. The MA5B receives a 60-round magazine. The weapon is able to use the M118 full metal jacket armor-piercing rounds or shredder rounds. It is capable of firing both fully automatic and in 3-round bursts, and when firing automatically, it can fire a spray of 15 rounds per second. Alternatively, MA5Bs could be loaded with hollow point bullets, which were highly effective against unarmored targets while leaving the surrounding environment intact, reducing on over-penetration. These ammunition types were distinguished by the red paint on their magazines. The rifle also has a modified variant that was adapted for use with a removable suppressor. The MA5C individual combat weapon was an improvement upon the MA5B, featuring heavier barrel with a 1-in-7 twist, a stronger magazine spring mechanism, a lower profile electronics housing, and a sturdier, more ergonomically designed trigger guard. It receives a shortened 32-round magazine. The reduced magazine capacity in relation to the MA5B is part of an effort to prevent wearing of the magazine spring. It is used by the Marine Corps and the Navy in short to mid-range combat. A downside to the MA5C was the lack of a secondary weapon system. However, by December 2553, the weapon was able to use the M301 grenade launcher. The MA5D individual combat weapon system receives a 32-round magazine like the MA5C, and also an increased capacity 36-round magazine. At some point before 2557, it became the standard issue fully automatic rifle of all UNSC branches. It possesses a built-in ammunition indicator and a magnetic compass for orientation similar to that of all of the other MA5 series rifles. It bears few noticeable design differences from the MA5C apart from an integrated muzzle brake. It saw continued use throughout the war, though the MA5Bs and C variant remained more common. In 2557, the MA5D had become standard issue, and it is now favoured due to its ruggedness and ability to withstand the conditions that are often faced on frontier colonies. The MA5D featured a plethora of additional attachments and compatibilities that weren't available for earlier versions of the MA5 series, including but not limited to an energy bayonet, extended magazine for a total of 54 rounds per magazine, laser targeter, stabilization jets, silencer, threat marker, and more. The concealed rail allowed the installation of various attachments. The primary scope, for example, is the built-in projection scope displaying a holographic tracked projectile on the user's heads-up display. However, the rifle is also compatible with the COG sight, the hybrid sight, a modified Covenant carbine scope, the long shot sight, the morph sight, a modified light rifle sight, and the recon sight. The MA5K carbine is a carbine variant of the MA5 that used almost exclusively by Special Forces units. The MA5K is a cut-down version of the standard MA5B assault rifle. It is fully automatic and receives a 30-round magazine of 7.62x51 FMJ AP ammunition. The most conspicuous difference between the MA5K and the other MA5 models is the replacement of the distinctive electronics housing with a removable carrying handle similar to that of the BR-55 battle rifle. The handle probably integrates a digital ammunition counter like the BR-55 and other MA5 models. That concludes all currently known information in regards to the infamous MA5 series, which leaves me to say, thanks for watching. Stick your comments down below, I look forward to what you have to say. I want to give a quick shout out to my patrons, Sir Tenshi, the Silent Cartographer, Brian, Sebastian, Holden, Nathan, Red Sea, Darien, and Neek, the Holders of the Mantle, Ty, Black Biscuit, J-Rabbit, Austin, Kaiser, Silux, Reclaimer216, and the Revanche, my Reclaimers, Zach, Deep Cover, Verbal Statue, Spesser Ghost, Spartan A498, Guppy, Josh, Mickey, Bastion, Molshar, and Slithery Tube Dude, my Metarchs, and all the other patrons that have jumped aboard to support the channel. You guys are awesome, and all of this wouldn't be possible without you. If you like Halo Lore discussed to insane levels of detail, hit that subscribe button and the little bell icon so you're told the second a new video hits the shelves. Be sure to support us on all major social media channels, including Discord, and if you really love the channel, consider heading over to Patreon and supporting the channel over there. It would mean the world to me and would free up more of my time for me to put into this content and other Halo-related goodness. Take it easy, everyone, and find peace in the domain.